Likewise, with regards to the hearts, today we are happy, tomorrow we are sad, so on and so forth. Nothing stays the same, ya ibad. We will either be increasing or decreasing. So now the choice is yours. What do you want for yourself? Do you want to increase or do you want to decrease? And within this, there is a tremendous lesson. There is a tremendous benefit for those who ponder, for those who reflect. The mere fact that things do not stay the same, the mere fact that things change, in this there is a lesson, there is an admonition. In looking at those things that we can change, we benefit. And in looking at those things which we do not have the ability to change, we still benefit. Imam Ibn Jawzi, rahimahullahu ta'ala, he says in his tafsir, قال البعد الحكماء, he says, some of the wise, they used to say, من كان اليوم على حالة والغدا على حالة أخرى فليعلم أن تأبيره إلى سواه. He said, whoever is today upon a situation and tomorrow upon another situation, then know that he is not a controller of his own self. Then know he is not a controller of himself. And anyone who is arrogant enough to believe so, to believe that he can change that which he does not have the ability to change, believe that he can affect and he can have some type of impact upon those things which he cannot change, then I will challenge you, stop breathing and let's see how that works out for you. No longer eat, and let's see how that works out for you. No longer sleep, don't sleep again. Let's see how that works out for you. You will find that you do not have the ability to alter or change these things. They're out of your control. In this there is a lesson for the one who is arrogant. In this there is a lesson for the one who deems himself to be self-sufficient. In this there is a lesson for the one who thinks that he is the only one who controls his affair. This is not the case. You do not control your affair. You do not have a choice in these matters. So in these matters of which we do not have a control in, there is a lesson. What is that lesson, ya ibad? That lesson, like Imam Sa'di, rahimahullah ta'ala, he says it in his tafsir. He said, أَنَّ هَذِهِ الطَّبَقَاتِ أَلَّتِي جَارُ عَلَى الْعَبْدِ يدل على أو دال على أن الله وحده هو المعبود. He said that these changing of situations, these changing in different situations which come upon the slave, it points to the fact that verily Allah Ta'ala, He is the one who deserves to be worshipped alone. That Allah Ta'ala, He is the one who deserves to be worshipped alone. Al-Wahid, Al-Mudabbir, He is the arranger of the affairs. Al-Mudabbir, Al-Ibad, Bihikmatih, Wa Rahmatih. He arranges the affairs of His servants by His wisdom and by His mercy. Wa kadhalika, and also it points to what? Ala anna al-abd faqir, ajiz, تحت تدبير العزيز الرحيم. He said it also points to the fact that the slave, the servant, he is poor, impoverished, does not have the ability over these matters. He is under the facilitation, he is under the control, he is under the arrangement of the Almighty, the All-Merciful. So in this, ya ibad, looking at those things of which we do not have the ability to change, we learn and we benefit that the facilitator, the arranger of these things is Allah Ta'ala. And it shows us that the one who has arranged these affairs, the one who has set these things into motion, then he is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. And as far as those things which are worshipped other than him, then they themselves are also compelled in these affairs and have no ability in these affairs. So how then therefore do they deserve to be worshipped, but rather organizer, al-mudabbir, the one who is the arranger, the controller of these affairs, he is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. And we benefit from these things, ya ibad. We benefit from these things, ya ibad, that the tawheed must be established for Allah Ta'ala alone. And in the alteration of the night and of the day and of years and of time and passing of situation for situation, we learn and we understand what? La ilaha illallah. That nothing has the right to be worshipped in truth except Allah Ta'ala. هذا يا عباد أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم واستغفروه. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. After looking at that which we benefit from those things of which we do not have the ability to change, let us turn to now those things of which we do have the ability to change. Because Allah Ta'ala has given to every individual from the human beings and the jinn of free will. We can choose whether or not to be obedient to Allah Ta'ala or to disobey Allah Ta'ala. وَكُلْ هَذَا بَعْدْ تَوْفِيقِ تَوْفِيقِ اللَّهِ. And all of this is after the success from Allah Ta'ala. فَعَلَى كُلِّنْ. The choice then therefore will rest to us. Do we want to be better or do we want to be worse? Do we want to increase or do we want to decrease? Do we want to be more knowledgeable or do we want to slip away into a deeper ignorance? Because bila shak, do not think that you will learn something and say upon that. Either you will be increasing in it or you will be becoming more ignorant. Imam al-Shafi'i, the great Imam, rahimahullah ta'ala, he says in his lines of poetry, he says, كلما أدبني الدهر أراني نقص العقل وإذا مزدت علما زاد علما بجهلي. He said, every time I'm shown a lesson by time, every time time shows me a lesson, it points out the deficiency of my intellect. He said, it points out the deficiency of my intellect. He said, because if I'm not increasing in knowledge, then my knowledge will be increased by my ignorance. Naam. Those who have memorized something from the Quran, you know this is the truth. You memorize a surah today. If you do muraji'ah, if you do review, then you will find next week it will be stronger than it was when you first finished it. If you keep doing review, it will become stronger and stronger. Whereas if you neglect it, you will forget this portion. You will forget that portion. If you neglect it for even more, you may forget the surah tamaman, completely, totally have forgotten it. So it will not remain the same. What you know now is not going to be what you know tomorrow. Now whether tomorrow it is better or it is worse, well that depends on what you're going to do. How many of us now, as we have reached the month of Rajab, couple of months from Ramadan, look back to last Ramadan, look back to how much you have memorized from the Quran, look back to what you have memorized from the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look at yourself right now. Where are you? Are you better or are you worse? Have you done more or have you neglected your own self? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he tells us in authentic hadith, من حسن الإسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says, from the good Islam of an individual is that he leaves alone that which does not concern him. Naam, how many of us know this hadith? Many. How many of us understand what is meant and intended by this hadith? As the ulama explained, if it is from a person's good Islam to leave alone that which does not concern him, and they explain, لا يعنيه أي لا ينفعه. What does not concern him, meaning it does not benefit him. لا ينفعه, does not benefit him. They say, so if it is from a person's good Islam to leave alone that which does not benefit him, then by default, in contrary, it is from a person's good Islam to concern himself with that which benefits him, is to take to that which benefits him. So now, are we of those who are described in this hadith from those who have the good Islam, who leave alone that which does not concern them, and who concern themselves with that which concerns them, who concern themselves with that which benefits them? From Ramadan to Ramadan, what is our development? Do we know more of the Quran or do we know less? From Ramadan to Ramadan, what is our benefit? Do we know more of the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or do we know less? From Ramadan to Ramadan, what is our benefit? Have we increased ourselves in knowledge of the deen or do we know less? From Ramadan to Ramadan, what is our benefit? Are we higher in our iman or are we less? Do we pray more or do we pray less? Have we fasted more or are we fasting less? Are we increasing or are we decreasing? Are we getting better or are we getting worse? This is not but a reminder, ya ibad. Because you will go from state to state until death comes to you. You will go from state to state until death comes to you. With regards to the assembly line of life, as I want to call it. Assembly line meaning that it goes in one direction, doesn't stop. You can't stop it, you can't push reverse. It goes in one direction. From one point to the other point.